So we have a really good game, you know. But there is one reason we are not, we are almost losing, is because we are not resetting fights often, you know.
Take this jungle.
Now this is one of the best power spikes in the whole game. You always wanna be on the move, you wanna click your basic attacks, not hold them. Because in high pressure environment, you know, if you stop, you're dead. So that's why I like Fingerbird is good, because you gain HP, critical reduction and movement speed and anti-slowity. And slow are actually really strong crowd controlling spike.
Okay.
Fingerblade, pretty good. Good survival stacks, you know. I'm good against magicals.
Okay,
we did a good damage to two guys, so Nuki's like, what is this damage? Now next item is going to be another flat pin item. We go probably Brawler's Beat Stick. So good for, you know, power pin and applying anti hit. Trying to save as much people as we can. You see, you always wanna be on the move. You cannot afford to stand still and use basic attacks, especially in environments like arena. Okay. Now we need like 200 more gold so we can afford tier 2 pin item. You already gained 10 penetration, so it's really good. You know, bam, bam. What do we need here? Yeah, Hydra, okay, so once you put Hydra on Mid Shibalanki, you know, you have two flat pin item, you have Warrior Tabby Power Spike, you have Winged Blade Survival, you just get Hydra, your damage almost doubles, you know, each basic after ability is bonus damage. And this is what the Mid Shibalanki is all about, you know, cancelling, animation cancel with your abilities. We need Winged. Oh shit, this guy has a lot of damage. So you wanna go hybrid build, you know, you don't wanna go full damage build in arena, but you know, even full damage works, you know, but maybe one item like for survival is pretty good. Ooh, double siege tower, let's see. Okay, quick poke for my guy. I have actually a lot of magical protection from Winged Blade and Ruling Shield. They have mostly magical damage and these two counter items are actually very important. So I can go... I can play a little more aggressively and... Now I have also 30% cooldown. So this is what arena is all about, you know, pushing and retreating. You don't wanna over push and you wanna get kills when you can. You wanna push them back like they're pushing now, so let's go. GG, well played. Let's know this guy, I think it's Blade Proc. Okay, well. Maybe good. Nice, nice. You just need to punish them when they over push. And you need to reset fights often. That's really basically how you play arena. and you know counter items, you know, Runic Shield on a warrior against the magical, Switchblade against counters, Void Stone when you have two mages in your team, and Stone Binding is a third item, you know. Third item is one of the most important items in Smite. You can basically get, you know, a breach item like Stone Binding, you can get counter item like Runic Shield on a warrior against three magicals, or you can get like good consistent item like Jotunheimwrath. Yeah, third item is really important. You only want to combine stats, you know, for pain items, for cooldowns, and survival stats. Maybe they can do it alone, but I'm not sure. Oh, nice, nice. Looking good. Not sure, did you get the tower? Oh shit, they... Ah, they GG. GG. I'm dead from me. Ah, GG. The task beneath me. Farewell, but no matter. GG, well played. They changed the name of a god Isis to Aseth, and she actually has some really good voice lines. So let's see how much damage did we do. 40,000, huh? Pretty good. I could hit more, you know, but 40,000 is really good, man. You know, 20,000 is like your average, you know. My team didn't even reach 20k, no one. Anyway, Shibalanki and Fenrir did a lot of damage here, because, I don't know, yeah, but they do a lot of damage, basically. So, Regenity, or maybe, I should get Witchblade before for physical protection, you know, but, so Regenity and Witchblade are good against 3 physicals, but in this case, they only had 2 physicals, you know, and 3 magicals. So, our warrior should definitely get Runic Shield, since they have 3 magicals, and... Because, you know, you can't let enemy mages just free cast, you know, you need to harass them. Especially in arena, you know, and this is why you have a warrior. And you always wanna have one warrior so you can get Runic Shield and, you know, maybe Witchblade. And one guardian so you can get Stone Binding, Witchblade, Void Stone, you know, and all these counter items. Maybe we actually need physical protection, but you know, at this point I wanna get more damage, so probably gonna get, you see my build, up, down, you see. Yeah. You see my build, like, movement speed, power spike, you see my build, guys, you see, I have, you know, power spike item, survival item, and now I go another power spike item. Now we just add in Hydra, and this will bring our build together, and we'll have it will almost double our damage, because we do basic 2, basic 3, and each basic after ability deals 40% more damage. So good. I 2, I basic, I 3. I don't have physical protection, that's the problem. Yeah, I need physical protection, just because I need it. So, if you need physical protection, Void Shield is actually really good. It's a little expensive, but you gain physical protection and 15% physical penetration for all your teammates too. So, for me, Shibalanki and Moonlight. Especially good when you have 3 physicals. In most conquest games you have 3 physicals, but in most arena games you have 2 magicals. I do what I can, but... Probably that I'm slow. I can slow them too. Farewell. You have been slain, dummy. I can use more. Attack! Cancel that! Attack! Let's go. No, it's not locked in yet. We can still win this, you know. We're only like 40 points behind. That's nothing. You know, last 10 tickets only big minion counts. This is one of the anti-snowball mechanics of Arena. Run! Gate run! Too basic too. Yeah, you need to counter build an arena, otherwise you're just gonna get focus and it will be frustrating. At least go winged build or something, like, just like me. Okay, we got him. That's really good, I have an ulti ready. And now... let's go Hydra, let's sell this item. Starter and get... Usually sell your starter item for 4 or 5 items. Let's go. This one doesn't need to die. It's not tanky. It's not tanky, I think. Well, actually, he is. He's a good hybrid build with some pin items. Let's get some wood. Oh shit, that was too late. Be careful. Be right back. That was I always come for pain. Ultimate is down. I have 20 seconds until I get ulti. Okay. I got two pain items this time, it's pretty good. But yeah, I'm lacking some damage. I just get Hydra, so it's way better. But maybe, you know, they have you press T and you can see top enemy damage. I see Shiba Lanky. So maybe we actually get we either get Pro Shield or we get Witchblade. Witchblade is actually so good, especially against Hunters, and if you don't get Witchblade, you know, you can't really fight Hunters in the Legend. I have some magical protection, so I'm good. Oh shit. Nice, nice. Get the Gip. The Gip. Let's get him. Nice. Yeah, let's go back. We actually catch up, you know, now it's only like 15 points. Okay, a little bit more. Hope they don't die on the middle. Let's get Witchblade soon. Once we get Witchblade, we can actually fight enemy Shiba Lanky and Ferreira. Shiba Lanky, I mean, yeah, Shiba Lanky and Witchblade are both very underrated. Witchblade is especially good against 3 physicals and essential against Hunter. So yeah, especially if you have aggressive playstyle, you need to go winged blade. Oh shit, we good. Now I gain a little bit more HP from winged blade and adventure blade, you know, hit points. Cut. Yeah, I used it to ulti. Yeah, we click. Nah.